Welcome once again here. We're coming to you from Jalsa USA in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. My name is Adnan Burke. I'll be your host for this afternoon session. As always, it's a pleasure to have you with us and appreciate for all those who are unable to attend here in person. We love the fact that all of you here on MT are able to see what we'll be able to convey from another wonderful Jalsa so far. I was able to listen to the afternoon session and I thought a lot of these speeches were terrific. So I'll offer a brief summary of each of them in case you didn't have a chance to see them, and perhaps you can find them online or transcripts and go on from there. So Irfan Chaudhry spoke first about Allah, the ray of hope in the darkness of despair. And I thought he had an excellent speech here. You know, he's speaking about symbols and about how in today's world, it's really hard to guide people away from social media. So as a father and talking to other fathers as well, it's important to tell your children to try to stay away from social media. And he said, you know, it's one thing to tell them not to have a Facebook account or don't post that picture on Instagram. But he really spoke passionately about the issue of cyberbullying and how for a lot of young Ahmadi kids, if you have a picture up there, all of a sudden people are going to say cruel things about them. And it encourages a level of behavior of selfishness and putting yourself forth, whereas obviously in Islam and in Ahmadiyyat, we're always trying to be subservient and make clear that Allah is number one always in our hearts and in our minds, and that we shouldn't always be putting ourselves out there. So he really explained powerfully how social media, and particularly Facebook and Twitter and Instagram, really shouldn't be something that is encouraged unless it's been for, obviously, for Islam's benefit, for Ahmadiyyat. It's not something that's being done for selfish pursuits. And particularly at the high school level, he said it can be very tricky because people are doing it to be vain and do not necessarily have the best aspirations. So it's important to always make sure that Allah is that ray of hope in the darkness of despair, as Irfan Bhai spoke about. Another excellent speech from Maulana Abdullah Dibba was, "My companions are like stars, inspiring narrations of young devotees." And Maulana Saab spoke very passionately about stories about Promised Messiah, alayhi salam, and just about how, you know, lessons from his life can always be conveyed to all of us here. And just because, you know, those stories may have happened from over 100 years ago, that does not mean that they're not still relevant today. And so we can always look back not only at stories, obviously, of hadiths involving Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but also from Promised Messiah, alayhi salam, and all those stories about him, and really the importance of companions and brotherhood. And I'll speak more about that in just a second, because Abdul Latif Bennett, he spoke about a step towards the mosque, a stride towards Allah. And I'm not much of a mathematician, but he spoke specifically in terms of math. And he said the difference between when someone is walking is 2.5 feet. So he said, if you think and look at every step that somebody makes, you know, that's a step towards Allah. And he spoke specifically about the importance of doing namaz, doing salat, in terms of congregation. And he said, you know, if you take 100 steps towards the masjid, then you're doing 2.5 feet times, you know, 100, do the math on this, that's, you know, 2,200 feet towards Allah. And all of that distance is what's important. Now, he also said the key is not how much distance you travel towards getting to a masjid or doing namaz, in doing salat in congregation. It's the fact that in your heart, the importance of doing namaz in congregation, that's what's most important. So whether you're driving 1 hour or you're walking 10 minutes, what's most important is that Allah is recognizing that you believe doing salat in congregation is important. And, you know, we've often heard the expression, you know, that it's 27 times more blessings doing namaz in congregation than doing it in person. But he really spoke passionately about why that's so important, and doing 5 daily prayers in congregation will offer so much blessings. In fact, he said, if you do Isha namaz in congregation, it is as if you prayed for half the night. And if you do Fajr namaz in congregation, it's as if you prayed all night. So there's really importance here in the terms of unity and blessings that you get from doing salat with others. And oftentimes people will just be in a rush and say they'll do it by themselves. It's not a big deal. But clearly it is a big deal because you get all those extra blessings, and that whole concept of brotherhood and sisterhood is really important. Last piece also from Ali Murtaza. That was about the Dawat Ilalala. That was preaching with the passion of Noah, alayhi salam. So, of course, for many of us, we know the story of Noah's Ark and just how he was so important, instrumental figure. And I think this is important in terms of tabligh, because if you talk about Prophet Noah, you can discuss him you know, not only with Jews, but also Christians, not only with ourselves as Muslims as well. So Prophet Noah's whole thought process and his belief and the fact that he had, you know, spiritual guidance from Allah and was able to act in terms of the famous story of Noah's Ark and taking one animal of each and putting them in the ark and guiding them and finding them shelter is a real example of trying to find blessings wherever you may find them. We always should look for symbols from Allah. So we have a terrific program here for you coming up for the next few hours here on MTA. Once again, my name is Adnan Virk. We are coming to you from USA Jalsa. It is our pleasure. Stay with us. We have plenty more coming up. Lots of great guests are on the way.